Show. 32, Casey Bianco. 5, Anna Simpson. 6, Dan Diego. 7, Tamika Peters. 8, Laura Gambrell. And 9, Aaron Willis.
All right, here, folks, we have our initial lineups here. In gray, of course, is Butler State Roller Derby. In pink and black. Star Source E2 lining up from Winnipeg to start things off. Number 2, Rachel Garris. And your first lead jammer is going to be Scar to Beat You. And we have a Scar Pass to number 3. Number 3 is Rachel McIver. It's a power jam, it's a penalty. The back block goes to Scar to Beat You. Back on the track now, back in the mix. Nice hop by Rachel MacGyver. Well, that was Scar to Beat You. Beat You. Driving back to the inside, able to continue. Another cut here called on 11:07. That's the second jammer penalty. First one was a back block. So this is an All About Derby power jam here for Mother Skate Roller Derby, Mother State. They skate like mothers, they're Mother State. I think we're just readjusting the scoreboard right now. Don't get confused, don't get scared. That was, of course, a full 2-minute jam. We'll have the score up there in a minute. Lining up in gray, who do we got?
We have Courtney Prendergast for Mother State.
And of course, Scarlett Beat You is starting off in the box. In this All About Derby jammer start. Prendergast gets lead jam with a quickness. That's the official score up there right now, 5-9. Prendergast taking a little header there on the inside. Penalty called on 1-11 there. Did you catch the penalty? Out of play on 11. One point score by Winnipeg. On the same, we got 4. We got Rachel Garris out there for Mother. Going up against 204. This is a robot driven power jam as Lex Go is in the box for a crack cut. Garris strikes away, dodges a big hit from the from the pivot in a way the ref does not. threw out another pass, piling on the paint right now. Lexco is back in, and that's the initial pass. Like five more points picked up by Mother State, 6-18.
Yep. So you've heard us talking about our All About Derby Power Jam. All About Derby is located right here on track two, offering protective gear, skates, and fun accessories, such as derby kits and long strap panty packs. You know you're not cool unless you've got your panty pack.
Picks up five. Some confusion regarding a jammer penalty on Mother, but she's gonna sit. That was an inside foul, I believe. It's All About Derby Power Jam, brought to you by All About Derby, obviously. That's a 15-point jam for Winnipeg, biggest jam for them thus far this game. This power start is All About Derby power start.
Star 2B2 breaks right through on her initial very quickly, coming up on a scoring pass. She nearly makes it up the outside with an amazing close stop work.
Power back out of the box and back in the mix now. Power comes to initial pass. Gartu Michu hops the apex. She's through. And punched. Five points for Winnipeg on that. Brings the score to 25-26. And that is a lead change. 28 with the Canadians over the Virginians. Under 20 minutes set to play, and Asher Cat lining up for Winnipeg.
And we have Rachel McKinner lining up for Mother State.
McKinner's first appearance as a jammer. She took the star in the first jam. McKinner from downtown comes through with each jammer. Cat chasing her down right now. The giver cuts to the middle. After Cat sneaking around the outside. And after some funny advice from the bench, calls it. Looks like a late forearm call there. Not quite seeing who's going off. Number two, the pivot for Mother State. That's Richard Garrett. And a timeout being asked for and given to Mother State.
If you're out here in the audience getting a little thirsty from all that cheering, make sure you go grab some beer. Beer is $6, but you get the collectible cup for $10. You can refill it for only $5. So make sure you go get a cool collectible cup and refill that beer.
This is fine advice by Jeremy Collier, ASAP. After a big start here, Mother State scoreless in the last four jams. Coming to the line right now is number 13, Nikki Towner, team captain, looking to reverse this trend. She'll be going up against Scarfield D2, who's on Team Canada in Winnipeg. Garcho beats you out of the inside line there. She's through and you're lead jamming. Counter knocked to the outside. Big ball in the front, but she recovers quickly. Garcho beats you on the inside. Takes up 4 points. They're going to keep this going. Garcho beats you high in the back of that pack. As Tana completes her first scoring pass. Starts to reach her, making quick work of that pass. Nikki Towner not doing so bad herself, but she cuts her in through. Starts to reach her, tries to hop it, goes down. Big hit in the front of that pass to number 22, the Snake Speed, the captain for Winnipeg. And Scarfo V2 is chasing Towner. Looking for the call and they're going to let him skate. V2 now to the inside, pulled back by number two. That's Rachel Garris being the pivot. Another hit from Garris. Assistant Tamika Peters. Closed up for both jammers looking for an exit. And Towner finds it. No! Calls the jam. That was Pichu, not Towner. So they end up with a net of 4 points on a huge jam, net of 1 point, 15-16. Biggest jam for both teams there, unsurprisingly. 48 to 40. I see Lex Go on the line.
And Rachel Garris on the line for Mother State. Lex Go has broken through, grabbed one.
Garris following her out of the pack. Next is a little hop and a call, and 4 points quick. Seventeen left to play. The score is 40-52. We're taking the lead in Ashton Cat on the line. She'll be joined by number 7, Tamika Peters, in her first jammer appearance. Number 11, my bad. She's been here before, Courtney Pendergast. Oh, big hit for number 22. Culminating in a forearm on number 32 from Mother State. Only one defenseman out there, and now she's joined by some of her teammates. Just under 15 left to play.
Rachel McKibber is out for Mother's Day alongside Sparky Me Too for Winnipeg.
Sparky Me Too knocked to the inside. The illegal contact being called.
Sparky Me Too has
Jeeps her way into the pack, but Mother State is there to meet her. Escaping from the pack on her initial pass is Rachel McGibbon. That's going to close the call off and start to meet you. No point score. No, that's not true. 3 point pickup. That brings Winnipeg's score to 65. Still at 40 for Mother State.
For this next one, we have Let's Go lined up with Lindsay Towner.
Towner only has two black jerseys in front of her. They fight, but unable to hold her back. Nikki Towner is through. First lead jam in 5 for Mother State. Chasing her down is Let's Go. And she just likes wet.
Let's Go jumps the apex. Lansing gets 4 points.
4 non-lead points here for Winnipeg.
High fives all around.
No, it was a high floor. It was 4 points. Actually, it was 3 points. My jump was really that good. Oh, well. It's four. The disaster cat going up against Courtney Pendergast.
Courtney almost makes it around the out, then takes a big hit, moving back around on the outside line. Ashford cat's in the same position, has 3 shoots to the back, start over on her pass.
D3PO with some tremendous defense back there, pulling Pendergast back and back. The sister of Jammer Scarto Beachy. sometimes fan of LGBTQ. I think that's right. I hope that's right. If not, congratulations, your family now.
Derby really brings people together.
Absolutely. All right, Astrocat gets through. She's your lead. Took her 50 seconds. That's a good defense there on both sides. Pendergrass passes the star to number two. That's Rachel Garris. Garris, does she get in the pack in time? No. No point scored. A single point. 2 points. Two single points for Winnipeg. Left to go in the first half of this contest. Mother State is going to be ECDX before. Last year they were here and they won over Tri-City. This is Winnipeg's first appearance.
Scar2B2 so quick off the line, no one can even challenge her. Grabs the band for Winnipeg.
Rachel Garris is through as well. Garrison Nietzsche, that's 4 points, and she calls it. Garris not able to engage in time. Score still falls to 40 for Mother State. Scoreless these last 6 games. Around the outside. Lex goes back in the action there. We need a triangle on Mother State defense. Tries the inside lane, no love there either. Rachel McGivern meanwhile is 2 for 5, and that's a full 2 minutes. That is a big jam for Mother State as they pick up 14 points. For Mother State. Look at the pull even after a big jam last jam by Nick Together. Jermaine DeBrawl, DiTrufio lining up at the front there. Good offensive attack by Mother State trying to break that up. As Winnipeg continues to kill the penalty.
And Tanner called off of him from the floor with a 9-point jam.
Mother State really tearing back here. 23 points in these last two jams. It looks like Winnipeg wants to sort of put a pause on that momentum. Who's this pause brought to you by?
Well, speaking of pause, it's brought to you by Moreau Regime Cosmetics.
I see what you did there.
It's a good one, right? They've got some beautiful cat-themed, derby-resistant liquid lipsticks. Say hi, give them a try. Take their interactive quiz and find out which cat and color is your perfect match.
Winnipeg rocking 11 lead jams thus far. Mother State picking up only 5 so far at the 26 points. The only 26 minutes and 26 seconds going, of course. These teams pretty well ranked, pretty well put up one against one another here. Mother State at 87, Winnipeg at 71. WFTDA sanctioned game. They've never met at the track before. That's the joy of a place like ECDX. You get teams from all over the place up against them. Alright, Garris takes on Astrocat. Astrocat kind of bullying Garris over the outside. Two leads in a row for Garris, and what was I talking about with Mother State really switching up the momentum in this game? Spins her way through the back of that defense, but lands outside is going to have to start over. Not for long on the inside, another spin, and she gets through for 5. We have a star pass as Astrocat hands it off to DiTrufio. Garris is going to call it. Total for that jam looks like 8. First star pass for Winnipeg. Forced into it there as they've been held scoreless last 3. As Mother State is on a tear. We got an 8-point game here.
Mother State's really pulling up from behind, closing that point gap very quickly. Now we have Prendergast. Jamming for Mother State, and let's go, jamming for Winnipeg.
5 minutes left to play as Pendergast takes lead jam. Pull out to the front. And we have a power jam. All about Jeremy power jam. Forearm on, let's go.
Prendergast toe stops up the outside line. Gets through for 5 points.
Oh, Pendergast trying to hop on by. She gets caught flying by number 22, Tenacious B, team captain for Winnipeg. Doesn't take her long to make it out though. There's 5 more points for Pendergast. And that's a lead change, folks. 10 points on the board for Mother State puts them in the lead. Let's go for future initial pass. Pendergast edge to the outside. She's going to call it. Lex unable to engage with the pack. Folks, this game is 79-84, and Mother State is ahead. 13 from Jan.
We have Scar 2B2 lined up to jam against Rachel Timber. Oh.
4 points picked up by Mother State in these last four games. Only 4 points picked up by Winnipeg at the same time.
Both jammers are through the pack, racing around.
Bit of a foot race now. Little jammer on jammer violence happening back there. Scarts will meet you in the pack. The giver working on her initial scoring pass. Scar pulled back. Nice spin and she's through to the front. That should be 4 points.
The giver, meanwhile, is hit to the out and pulled back to the back of the pack.
Scar to beat you, knocked to the outside. And a big hit from number 2, that's Rachel Garris. Scar to beat you almost had it, but coming out of nowhere. Rachel Garris once more is going to force the call on by Scar to beat you. And I do believe it was momentarily a tie, but now Winnipeg pulls ahead 88-93 after a 14-point jam. Under 2 minutes left on the clock as Astro Cat takes to the jam line. Going up against Nikki Towner. We got an empty penalty box as this one starts off. Astro Cat covers the metal. She's through. Keep sweet. As they say in other parts of Canada, not Winnipeg. And a trap cut on Towner makes this an all about Derby power jam for Astro Cat. Second jammer penalty for Mother State.
Astro Cat is pushing against that wall, finally breaks through, gets 5 more points. Astro Cat coming around.
Tight defense here, shutting this down as the period clock winds down to nothing, towards nothing. Astro Cat almost free, but number 11, Courtney Pendergrass catches her. Oh man, what a hit from number 32, Casey Bianco. That's going to send her out for, I believe, a backlash. And the period clock was done, so 5 points put up at the end of that. 5 points total, no, 10 points total. Bring it to 103-88. In a game that definitely could go either way. We'll see you back here in about 15 minutes. Well, it's been a pretty interesting game here, Giraffe. We have Winnipeg in the lead, 103-88. They got 13 versus 7 lead jams in that. But Mother State enjoyed 6 power jams over Winnipeg. Winnipeg only getting 2.
If we know anything about Mother State from this game, it's that they can turn around a point deficit very quickly. A few good jams or a few power jams, and Mother State can make a comeback.
Mother State's high score is Rachel Garris with 29. Nikki Towner right behind her with 24. Also helping out Courtney Pendergrass and Rachel McGiver. Over on Winnipeg here, that's Scarves who beat you with 48 points. Behind her is number 98 Astrocat with 41. And helping out there is Let's Go with 14 points. Definitely within striking distance here for Mother State, especially if they can put together a run like they did towards the end of the last one, where they got something like 47 points in 4 jams. Huge attack for Mother State. So the Red Bull and Canadian World Cry is coming up from Winnipeg over there. I would be very afraid right now. If I were a Mother Skate player, well, you know, I'd be ready to take him on. Scarves are going to take this one on the jam line as we start things off the second half.
And we have Rachel Garris jamming from Mother Skate.
Turns to 8-8, 11-92 with Winnipeg on top.
Courtney Prendergast is lined up against Let's Go.
We have 5-on-5 as we start things off here in the second jam of the second half of the 32nd game of the CCDX.
Let's Go pushes up the inside line, gets the jammer. Prendergast still trying to push through at the back. Winnipeg's wall is holding strong.
Prendergast recycled back, meanwhile to the front. Let's Go picks up 5. And we have a star pass going over to number 13. That is Nikki Towner.
Let's Go calls it off after she gets 4 points for her tag.
Astrocat taking to the jam line for the first time this half.
Rachel McKibber is up for Mother State.
Still a full personnel on the track. False start called on number 3 there. She has to yield her position, but no penalty given.
False start won't keep her down. She gets lead jammer.
First lead jam for Mother State in this half. The Cougars trying to make it count here. Edge to the outside. And we got a power jam on a merit of a forearm here. All about Derby power jam going to AstroCat.
Meanwhile, Winnipeg has passed off the star to D3PO. Winnipeg clears the inside line for her. D3PO gets through, gets 5 points.
D3PO tries to hop, it doesn't quite stick the landing. Going to be pulled back around turn three. Pushed to the outside there. And now McGivers back in the mix. Going to be 2 minutes here, no lead jammer on the track. Forearm being called on Mother State's number 19. She's off to the box. AJ Broderick.
The Kimmer is forcing Winnipeg to bridge out to the front. And she has picked up a forearm penalty. We have an All About Derby power jam.
Two forearms and one jam from McKinley.
That was a close jam with 9 points for Winnipeg, 8 points for Mother State.
One 25 to 100, that took Mother State up over that 100 mark. Scar2D2 gonna take this All About Derby jam.
Some very effective offense gets Scar2D2 right through the pack. The jammer.
Coming in hot of this pack. What a jump! Takes a little bit of a header, but she was fine. Goes through the pack the hard way that time.
McKibber is back on the track. Can they throw her into the pass now?
to walk off here with a little assistance. Well, there's a 14-point jam here. We're just going to clear our medical equipment from the track, and we'll be getting things going here. 100 to 139 from Winnipeg's 14-point jam. Against Nikki Towner here, starts with D2, making quick work of that patch to grabs lead. Towner out of the pack as well as Scarpy D2 picks up four. Quick four, a quick call.
If you go out to get a beer refill, make sure you stop by Wicked Skatewear on your way. They have custom printed roller skates, gear, and the best part, inappropriate jokes.
Nothing inappropriate going on here. We have a clean box with Rachel Garris takes on. Let's go. Let's go to recycle to the back as Rachel Garris takes off at the front of the pack. Your lead, Janner.
Garris spins around to the back wall, slams to the front wall, and she makes it through.
She's
point.
Chased down by Winnipeg's pivot there, but unable to catch her. Four points up for Garris. Astrid Cat taking the ride. She'll be going up against Courtney Pendergrass. Ready, 2 minutes left to play. Working on that inside line, Winnipeg says no way. Up in the front, Astrid Cat still working on her initial pass. Pendergrass pulls back again as Astrid Cat passes the star off to, I'm sorry, to Meat, Lady Meat, Girl Meat.
That was possibly the easiest star pass I've seen so far.
Teacher and number three, McGivern. A tidal wave of gray knocks Scarjavicu to the inside. McGiver also on the inside. Scarjavicu gets back quicker and gets out quicker. D3PO flying after McGiver there. It looked like she got a forearm, I think was the call. She's going to have to sit down. Meanwhile, 4 points picked up by Scarjavicu. And threw by McGiver. As these two teams trade body blows. Scarjavicu calls it, and the whistle is eventually blown. Scarjavicu rocking a very high lead jammer percentage. He's only failed to hit jammer, lead jammer once this entire game. Now Lex Go is on the line up against number 13. That's Nikki Towner, of course. Nikki Towner on the outside. She's through the lead. It is 2010 again here. My goodness. Is this a USARS game?
Neither jammer got any points on that one. He didn't quite get past any blockers.
Under 18 minutes left to play in regulation in the second half of this game. Scarjavicu going up against Nikki Pendergrass. Courtney Pendergrass. Scarjavicu is your lead jam.
Both jammers once again coming up to the pack at the same time. The pack is racing through. Prendergast has more luck. She gets out first.
And that's a fast journey.
Scarjavicu following behind. And that was a tied jam with 4 points for either side. Sponsor 5 Second Skatewear. They have everything you need for art and apparel.
It's going to be Lex Go against McGiver up there right now. McGiver got up there first. Lex Go now being pushed back. McGiver still working at the front. Bulldozes her way up there. She's your lead jammer. Let's go get a lot of static at the front. Number two, Rachel Garris trying to slow her down, unable to stop her assault. Four unreturned points right now for Mother State. 131 to 155, just under 16 minutes left to play.
Thank you.
two teams here very evenly matched the second half with 16 jams apiece. Two power jams offered up by Mother State thus far, and that was in a single jam. And that's Nikki Towner. Towner mixes it up in the pack, decides to call it. Starts to beat you up against Garris. Garris pulls back, Scar is out front, your lead jammer.
Garris runs up the outside and then makes it through.
Garris wrecked things up front, but she does get back to the inside at the last second. She should be recycled back around the turn. Meanwhile, Scar to beat you, continuing her lead jam streak here. She's through. Garris following her on the pack. I didn't even notice Scar Tupichu going through the pack that time. That was really quick and almost untouched. And another quick one for Scar. That was just a couple of steps and 5 points later. Low block on D3, PO, she's off to the box. Scarzo's D2, B2, up in front. Goes for the jump, doesn't quite land it. Garris still working on her scoring pass. That is a huge jam for Winnipeg as they put 28. Mother City does pick up 8 on the board right now. Biggest jam of the game, 28 points. We're going to pause the clock at 12:14. We're going to push the time out.
Brew's Boutique, one of our great sponsors, is set up over near Race 3. They have a huge setup. They've got all sorts of fun accessories, skates, hats, and they have some awesome skates. So go visit Brew's Boutique and talk to them about your perfect pair of skates.
Go, taken to the jam line. Prendergast going up against her.
Prendergast really quickly hit out by Clem Patel. Let's go, up center toe stop. On the inside gets Lee Jammer.
And we have a star pass by Prendergast. As she hands off to number 13, let's get the time. Let's go off to the box on a crack cut.
We have an all about derby power jam right now in favor of Mother State. grabs her 5 points and works her way back around for another scoring pass. She's hit to the inside and shoots to the back. Lexco is out of the box and we're on pass.
No lead jammer at this point. Going for the full two. Lexco wrestling her way back in the front there. Mother State not making it easy on her. Just backing into that blocker, number 32, Casey Piatto, holding her back, until she finally pushes out by. That was a nice jump by Lex Go.
If you know any junior derby players, make sure they check out the Philadelphia Roller Derby Summer Camp 2018. Junior skaters of all skill levels are welcome to participate in a week-long program teaching everything from the basics to advanced derby techniques.
All right, a little score adjustment up top there. That's a 14-13 jam for 198-155. We're going to take in the lead. Under 10 left to play here. The game is pushed to the inside. Nice hit by number 14, Amanda Braun. Number 69 off to the box and in position. Still fooling for position, and there we go. Rachel McGibber gets it.
Astro Cat almost out of the box. It gets hit by number 2, Rachel Garris. Has to come back around to try again.
Great star pass here as D3PO takes it from Astro Cat. That was really slick. Friendly fire there on the Winnipeg side. One 158 to 198 with Winnipeg on the lead. 8.5 left to play. On the line, number 13, Nikki Towner. She'll be going up against Girl Meets the Pivot. She'll be going up against Scarza Beach. On the inside, that starts to beat you for the jammer. And cuts the inside. Number for 7 off to the box on Mother Santa's Community Theater. On the inside, Scarjo Michu picks up another 5. Scarjo Michu up to 15 points on this jam. And counting, we have a star pass as Nikki Towner hands it off to number 8, Laura Gambrell. Gambrell crashes into that hole. And it was good enough to get 2 points. For the 19 points here for Winnipeg.
And those 19 points brings them up over the 200 mark. Right now we're sitting at 217 to 160. Rachel Garrick is going to be against Alexa.
Well, he's going to put her hands on her hips and call it dead. Although 2 points picked up in the back by Mother State, snaked away in an out-lead situation. Put the grass back on the line against Astro Cap. Off the line first, a little up in front. Pivot from Mother State, making her life a little miserable right now.
Very good bridging from Mother State, not giving up easily. Still holding after Cat's place.
AC Bianco is out here. That was a good one, but Astro Cat now trying to get by Casey Bianco up front. Bianco with another hit. She is Astro Cat's worst nightmare right now. Minute going. And still no lead. A cup track being called on number 11, Pendergrass to the box. Astro Cat has the opportunity. She's your lead jammer. First lead for Astro Cat this half. Astro Cat pulled all the way back to third two. And pulled back again as the jam is whistled dead at the 2 minute mark. 162 to 217. Astro Cat put up, looks like she got all 4. Timeout called by Mother State.
If you're looking to plan a vacation this year, tickets for the 2018 WFTDA International Championships go on sale in August. You can take a trip to New Orleans this November and go see the best team laid out on the flat track. Thank you.
D2 on the line right now. And there's all that derby power start. As Pendergrass still in the box with track that last year. Starfield all the way back around 10-4. Meanwhile, Pendergrass back in and completes her initial pass. Too sweet. That pack, she picks up 5, and there's a star pass by Mother State. We give her hands off to number 2, Rachel Garris, now headed off to the box. Casey Bianco, but a big blocker from Mother State this game. And I think that was a full 2-minute jam. We have just enough time for one more jam here. And a timeout is going to be called by Winnipeg.
If you're here again tomorrow, make sure you check out some of our cool classes here at UCDX. There's Skate Park 101, Sweat to the Oldies, Social Media Awesomeness, and a few more. So make sure you check out the class schedule. Go learn something new.
Winnipeg putting together 5 10-point plus jams this half. That has been definitely a good part of their success. Mother State only able to put together one such jam. That 23-point jam in the last one, not quite the highest jam. We did have a 28-point jam earlier. Clock is stopped at 31 seconds left in regulation play. And that is Star 2 beat you.
Right around the inside line for a speed jammer. Garrett is
Ooh, a rough take down there. All right, unofficial final score up on the board right now, 166 to 253. Winnipeg takes the game here. We'll have the final score in just a moment. Official final, still 166 to 254.
If you plan on sticking around for the next bout, you will see Jersey Shore versus River City.
And there we go, final score 166 to 254. Give it up for Winnipeg Roller Derby. Well, this is apparently not quite the final score. We're going to do an official review as requested by the Winnipeg. Silver, what's going on out here?
So it turns out at the end of the jam, Stephanie Beecher was expelled from the game for a bit of a contact with the referee. And Winnipeg was challenging that call. Winnipeg lost that review.
All right, put your hands together for both these teams, Winnipeg and Mother State. Hard fought game on both sides. We're going to get ready for the 10 o'clock game here as we are up all night. So change of venue here, in case you wanted to catch the Oslo Free State game. That is going to be over on track one due to a delayed game over on track two with the juniors. So if you want to see Oslo Free State, head on over with me to track one.
If you are looking for the open scrimmage that was to be on track one, it will be now on track three after the current game is over. Open scrimmage that was to be on track one is now on track three after the conclusion of the current game on track three. Thanks.
Number 2 Blonde Sided, number 3
have met 2004, once in 2016, with the 76th Day, 1963, that Junior Store 121, and all the way back in 2010, Junior Store 129, Junior City 119. So, these teams are overdue for a matchup.
Absolutely.
It looks
like we've got almost like a grudge match going on. Just about ready to start our first jam of the night. Well, of the game. It's definitely not the first jam of the night.
No, it's been out for a while. Now we got country jam going up against this number 8, Emma Effa.
Emma Effa, probably one of my absolute favorite girls.
Emma Effa. Pretty funny show.
Yeah, it is.
And this jam is about to get going.
Girl, it's about to go down.
And this means it's about to start. 0-0, we are ready for the final game on track 2, update 2 for ECDF 2018.
Emma Effa diving right into that pack, taking that inside line. Country Pam going to that outside line. Both jammers evenly matched. It looks like Country Pam coming up on top to get that lead jammer status. First lead jam of the game.
Emma Effa still working. This attack getting out. Now Country Jam bouncing on the outside. What's your bench? So we keep on going.
Picking up 4 points, and then she's gonna call that down. She's gonna hit it and quit it.
On the line down, before we listen, we got smack on the green. Identity. Lana Bowling.
Oh, I love a good pun. Puns are what make Derby though, in my opinion. And here we go, both jammers taking that inside line. Smack Mamba gonna change her strategy, try to go outside, but it looks like that wall of Jersey Shore skater is not gonna make it easy for her.
And a trap up on Smack Mamba. This is an all about Jersey power team. Exactly. We jam it for the sign of that lead.
Looks like River City's now got two sitting in the penalty box.
New position time on 679. And 7-1-1. 4-5 points. Grandson and 4-2-4.
Ooh, and a hip hit from the Jersey Shore pivot to to Smack Mamba.
Mamba dances on the outside. And another track that penalty on Smack Mamba. We gotta make this another power team for Jersey Shore.
And it looks like the pivot for River City, Mexican Ninja also taking a seat. It looks like it was a forearm penalty. Oh, River City taking out one of their own players in an attempt to take out Slam About Lee. Misdirection.
Spring pass again, it's 25. Sooner that lead coming through for another spring pass. It's going to be a good spring pass.
There's Blonde Sided and Foxy Foe trying to stave off Slamabelle Lee to no avail.
Very confused. Natural 2-minute conclusion. Not the first one that Lee was able to score all of 15 points on that jam.
We're sitting at
4-15 in favor of
Jersey Shore going into the third jam of the game.
Jersey Shore is up against 13-13. Portland. Portland bouncing at the point.
Andy Dauntless taking that inside line and then juking to the outside, taking lead jammer status.
Yeah.
Looks like we got ourselves a tag being called on Laura Quinn. We got ourselves an all-about Derby Tower Jam in favor of River City. Picking up a handful of points, Lady Dauntless making her way for her second scoring pass.
River City is setting up for the power to sweep. And a big sweep on the inside from Lady Dauntless going to make that dive in the sky for River City. First lead change.
Oh boy.
And Dauntless finding her on the inside, open up on the action ninja. Probably her win now back in the action.
So far this now makes Lady Dauntless the highest scoring jam as of right now, and it's only jam number 3. Can she go even higher with 33 seconds left? Is she going to call it, or is she going to go for the full 2 minutes?
This is the incoming time of the 35 here in the city. The incoming on the ticket goes in the show.
14 getting sent to the penalty box, blocked to the head. Looks like Lady Dauntless is gonna ride this jam all the way to the end. But it looks like, oh my goodness. It looks like she called it with seconds to go. And there we go, highest scoring jam so far, 33 points scored on behalf of River City. They are now in the lead with 37-15, going to jam number 4. Oh my goodness, what an exciting game already, and it's just started.
Every jam is such a high score, but it's not the most amount of effort. So everything is just going higher and higher. Basically, by the time we get to the end of this game, it's going to be really cool jam.
Adrenaline wearing the star for River City. Mick Jagger taking a seat in the penalty box. And Emma Effa is calling that jam.
Adrenaline trying to find someone on the outside. She throws it at 3 points. It will stay in balance. River City 40, River City 19.
Both teams have scored thus far, going into jam number 5.
Country team, we're going to say, up against Glenna Bellini here at Jersey Shore. Glenna Bellini
wearing some really fun shorts. I think those are donuts.
Donuts.
This is whistles are blowing and 6-7-9 in the box.
There we go, we got River City, got lead jammer status.
Country jam.
Still alternating leads at this point.
Country jam has a little hop skip of the jump. She's doing for 5 in the sky for River City.
Country jam just spreads herself on that track.
What's down with this? Put your game through 5 points. A misconduct call getting called on the last game ninja.
A misconduct call, according to our producer,
one of our producers, Blind Reed. Put your game through another slide. I'm telling you, by the end of this game, 100-point game is emerging. I've got getting assessed to the jammer, Santa Bell Lady. So this is going to be an all about River Power Jam to start the next jam in this game. River City up 55, Jersey Shore 19, 21 and a half minutes left in this contest.
Max
Mamba
is
going to
be wearing the star for River City, starting off with that all about River Power Jam.
Thank you. And Scott Mama for the lead, Jammer 4, River City. River City. Slam for the ends. Matt Mama just took it all. Jump under the outside of a Jersey Shore blocker.
This is the first time that River City has gotten consecutive lead jamming. Oh, that anybody, either team has gotten a consecutive lead jam. River City has broken that.
Matt Mama looking for some the outside throw. It's called on a blocker. Here at River City, Slimmer got Lee back in the action. Gets you on her initial pass. Matt Mama, oh, he tries to hop the outside. Gets knocked to the end there by Nathan Lucky.
One-sided
kicking
a seat
in
the penalty box for direction of play.
Big jam there by Smash Runner, River City, 9-8-3, 67-1-2.
Emma Effa takes the lead.
Emma Effa does well. Having the inside, Emma Effa is 2 for 3 for lead jamming.
Jersey Shore is 2 for 3 with lead jamming.
First time in the ring that we've seen both of these things at full screen.
And it's also the first chance for Mick Jagger. So let's see what he can do. Taking that outside line, Tim Jones through the pass, getting Lee Jammer.
And a track cut there on Nick Jagger. This is going to be an All About Jimmy power jam for the City.
This is going to be the second 2-minute jam of the game thus far. Nick Jagger losing lead jammer status and she flipped out. And Adrenaline is taking that power jam.
Nick Jagger, first time she's seen the start, but this is a third penalty of the game. Not finding a lot of luck, and then just got to the inside of the right hand Murphy. That's the gameplay on the pivot for Jesus Slay.
Tina Slay getting called for a direction and a misconduct. She's going to be sitting a full minute in the penalty box.
And the forearm getting called on Susie Slammer. That is Susie Slammer. I want to say it's your third penalty already. Four jam, River City leading, Jersey Shore 23, 16.5 minutes remaining. If you haven't had a chance yet, you should get some beer. You have $6 a cup, but if you can buy a thin bill, you can collect it for $10. It comes with no choice of giraffe, and you can refill it for only $5.
Number 29.
Remember I'm doing that out of time. Fun accessories such as ribbon discs and long strap baby packs. I love these baby packs.
Yeah.
Don't forget about All About Vivi. All About Vivi's special discount for referees. The one-stop shop for all your Vivi needs. Shop online at allaboutvivi.com. We are known, and I think you know by now, but ECDX is a WFCBA recognized tournament.
That it is.
It is in a very good company. And it is, I believe, the 12th year? ECDX has been around for quite some time. This is my first time here, but I would love to make it back.
So, quick note from our producing team, it looks like that Jersey Shore. Four jammer penalties in the first 9 jams of the game. Emma Effa up against Black Smack Mamba. Smack Mamba taking quick work of that pack. She's the lead jammer. Emma Effa not far behind. But Smack Mamba is not going to give Emma Effa any leeway. She's calling off that jam just as quick as you please, but not without scoring 4 more points.
River City 92, River City 23. Half, first quarter of the game finished. 3 quarters to go.
And then the Lee and Lady Dauntless coming in for jam number 11.
Thank you, Pat, up for a screen. And a basketball call on Sandoval Lee. He's going to be another power jam for River City and Lady Dauntless.
We got another 2-minute jam. Sandoval Lee losing lead jammer status. Lady Dauntless is going to take full advantage of this, I'm sure.
5-5-4 Lady Dauntless. River City setting up for some brilliant offense. Lady Popcorn throws over number 7 of the show, a bunch of mana. She's to 5 more points for the city. Back in the action from the box, she is served her turn. She pops out and gets her arm. Another strong pass gets 4 out for Jordan Short. Lady Dauntless doing now putting 5 more points on the board for River City.
River City crossing that century mark into 107 to 27.
Lady Dauntless pushing out the bat, a bunch of money. 6 seconds up in the game. And a back block in the remaining seconds of the game. Gonna make it All About Dirty Power Jam to start the next game. Oh,
looks
that's
like
a rough break there, Jersey Shore.
Looks like Jersey Shore is calling for an official review. We're gonna find out what it's all about, so stick around.
We're gonna take this second to tell you about Derby City Skates. Are your wheels getting tired? Derby City Skates is offering wheel removal all weekend. Stop by because wheels relight. Ron O'Reilly. Here to see the Steve Elbow has a huge selection of dirty stains here at EZBX, from sizes from small to 3XL, we've got you covered. Rick three. Our producer, Bob Yanko, coming out to the center, figure out what this official review is about. Meanwhile, to a bonheur, and who do we have here? Moreau, these cosmetics.
Oh, I love that.
They're amazing. Provides long wear, dirty resistant liquid, to matte lipsticks with catitude. Move the word catitude.
Love me some catitude.
Love that catitude. If I was wearing my dirty shorts, they'd have cats on them. Stop by, say hi, give it a try, take the interactive quiz and find out which cat and color is your favorite.
I took their quiz, I'm a Mean Jolene.
Me too!
Oh my god, Quincy!
Yeah, Quincy!
Blue wanted the jammer penalty rescinded. However, upon further review, the play stands as called.
So that means Jersey Shore will not retain their official review for the rest of this half. Looks like this official review is over.
So it looks like we're going to be starting off this next jam as an All About Derby Power Jam, as the River City Jammer is serving time for a cut track penalty.
There is
that Apex jam. That was a late call. Oh my. Mick Jagger taking a spill. But it looks like she is being called on a track cut, which will release Country Jam.
Now,
and we've got a change of power jam here.
Can't exactly do a big jump and spill and stand up like that.
She looks like she's gonna, it looks like Mick Jagger is only gonna serve about 23 seconds of a penalty.
Lee Jammer is still open since Country Jammer started in the box. And Lee Jammer is assessed for Country Jammer.
This is the first time either team has had three lead jams in a row. It's definitely been a lot of changeover here. Oh, Country Jam taking a seat outside the track as she takes a hit and she's gonna call it off. 121-31 is where the score is currently sitting, going into jam number 15. 9 minutes left of the regulation play for the first half. Slamabelle Lee up against Lady Gauntlet. And here we go. Slamabelle Lee gonna take that inside line, but it's getting knocked out by Country Jam, who's playing as a blocker. Gauntlet tiptoeing up against that outside line and taking Lee Jammer's status. Oh, we got ourselves an all-about Derby Power Jam. Lady Gauntlet is going to maintain that Lee Jammer status while Slamabelle Lee takes the seat.
That's number four for Slamabelle Lee as a jammer. What a jammer for that is.
Yikes. Yikes on bikes. Or skates.
That doesn't matter.
No, I'll think of a better one.
I like the effort. Lady Gauntlet's doing one's a beat in the front. Big hit there by 43, making Knuckles. She also let her go 5. Big rolls over points for Lady Gauntlet.
And the penalty box is clear. Slamabelle Lee coming in, trying to get her revenge on being sent in for that penalty.
Direction on court number 3, Lady Gauntlet's to calls it off.
She's gonna call it off. She's not gonna give Slamabelle Lee any chance to score any points. But it looks like a big old 14 points scored on behalf of River City. 135-31. Goodness. Jersey Shore has not scored in the past 4 jams, so it's up to, let's see if Emma Effa can break that streak up against Adrenaline.
Being a site doing a good job knocking the building to the outside of the building.
Oh! A landed apex jump earns Emma Effa 5 points.
Little now out of the door on that pass. And two calls it off. Let's see if she gets a point for that. No, does it look like she gets a point for that? A penalty being assessed to Audacity at the end of that jam. That looks like that was a little black.
This is the third jam where both teams have put any points on the board.
Jersey Shore winning that point 9-4.
Horror Quinn is wearing these stars for Jersey Shore. Country Jam for River City. And it looks like River City is going to be calling a timeout at this time.
Let me tell you about 5 seconds of streetwear.
Oh, please do.
Are you art impaired?
Yes.
You like to buy?
Yeah.
You want to hear a song?
I would love a high
five. Then stop by our booth if you have 5 seconds for all your art and driven needs. 5 seconds streetwear. 5 seconds streetwear is everything every here in needs in art, in apparel, to movies, to people on skaters, and yes, even you, Jimmy Williams. 5 seconds streetwear. Bobby Marco just ran over. Took 5 seconds, and there's one right behind the announcements right here. We've got these the dirty skins, like, things where you, like, it's like, you have those booty shorts that you slap and they, like, turn one color. What's your jam doing against horror playing? Jam. I think the jam is going on, but both of these jammers taking their turn.
Oh, Country Jam running on her skates to achieve lead jammer status. That was really impressive.
Country Jam feeling her blockers to met up. Chaos 7-3, that's a little drop size spin. Gets 2 points for her trouble. 141 to 45 is left to go in the half.
We've got a 101 point lead going into jam number 18. French Club, number 11. I believe this is her first time wearing the star for Jersey Shore up against Smack Mamba.
I love this name, French Club.
Ooh la la!
French Club gets knocked to the inside by Blasted Ninja. Smack Mamba also gets a jump back in turn 4. French Club getting knocked in, but Smack Mamba getting in a track cut on French Club. Gonna be on all about very for fire jam for whoever it is.
Oh,
and
Smack Mamba 3-4 in power jam. Alright, as in lead jammer, sorry. Still good.
It's still good. Smack Mamba 2-5 in the sky through the River City.
Nikki Knuckles trying to stave off a Smack Mamba to no avail. She is not as lucky. Oh!
And a missed crossover call on French Club, who cannot jump into a wall, unfortunately. Smack Mamba getting a trap on it.
So it's a race to the penalty box. And it's our fourth 2 minute. This makes it our fourth 2 minute jam. French Club being released. As soon as Smack Mamba sits down, Smack Mamba now released. Both teams back up to full strength. 26 seconds left of that jam, going to full 2 minutes.
And Blasting Ninja giving the business of French Club in the front, going all the way around 2-3. Walking out of bounds, though, because this is her team aggressive anyway.
Natasha Runyuo.
After all that business, 8-0 a jam, River City, 139-42, and a half minutes left to go in the half.
And this is just the first half, Kate. We are just getting started, it feels like.
Just revving up.
Absolutely.
A late night game.
Absolutely.
The midnight game.
Emma Effa up against, I believe that is Lady Dauntless.
Direction is going to flash the ninja to the back. That's going to be Blasting Ninja. Third key of the game.
Emma Effa is your lead jammer up against Lady Dauntless, but it looks like Emma Effa being sent to the penalty box for a cut track. Lady Dauntless got ourselves an All About Derby Power Jam.
And that is our fifth 2 minute jam out of the game.
It's a back to back 2 minute jam.
What have you? These skaters must like skating if there are going to be so many 2 minute jams. Lady Dauntless coming through 5 through River City. Rossi and Midran giving the Blitz some business, trying to play some O. And Lady Dauntless easily clockwise block assessed to Winter. Five more.
Looks like 732 blue is being sent to the penalty box on illegal contact. That is Winter Wanterland.
And the aftermath on him is a pass. Lady Dauntless more or less skating laps on here. Four more points. Emma Effa working her way in on her first scoring pass. Last line of defense blasting injury. She'll get by her hips. 4 points for Julie Shore. Meanwhile, Lady Dauntless to report for more. Emma Effa coming through for some more. Lady Dauntless through. 10 seconds left in the jam. And Emma is going to come through one more point. So, both sides throwing a good deal of points, but River City winning the game 25-8.
And it looks like we are at the half. We're going to be back in about 9 minutes. 174-48. We'll be right back. Stick around. Let's see how this plays out. So thanks to our fantastic producers here, we got some jammer totals here. The highest scoring jammer for River City currently is number 258, Lady Dauntless, followed by number 42, Country Jam with 33. Number 7, Smack Mamba, scoring 21 points. And number 26, Adrenaline, for 29 points in the first half. Some pretty impressive numbers. We're getting the numbers for Jersey Shore right now.
For Jersey Shore, 11 jammer box strips. So that is probably a very decisive factor in this game. You gotta keep your jammers on the track if you want to continue scoring on those points. And we have zero start passes in this game. On the line, we got a jammer on the board up against Emma Efras. Emma Efras leads the jammer for Jersey Shore.
First lead jam of the half going to Jersey Shore.
Nick Jabber from the back section, good penalty. Adrenaline for Emma Efras for 4 points. And she's going to call that out. First grab on the left for Jersey Shore. On the line now for Jersey Shore, we got Sandoval Lee going up against Country Jam for River City.
Country Jam and Sandoval
Lee. River City with the pocket advantage. Four on assault.
Called on two on blue number five, that's Cool Motif. Meanwhile, Country Jam scooping up that lead jammer status.
Turned by Lee, now working one to lead in the front in our gas room as he takes a trip. 4 or 5 points for Country Jam Grand Slam. And a little back move on Country Jam passing all the hits.
Country Jam frantically calling off the jam, almost taking out a ref.
Antonio all four, so 9-0 jam for River City.
183 to 152 going into jam number 3, 1313, Horror Quinn. And number 7, Smack Mamba, are your jammers. Going into jam number 3 of the second half of the last game of day number 2 of ECBX 2018.
Smack Mamba.
It's a hell of a day at sea, sir.
The Mamba is going to the outside.
Horror Quinn, here she goes.
Smack Mamba getting stuck up in the back of the pack. Horror Quinn coming out for a swing pass already. It's tripped up by Smack Mamba. And Smack Mamba getting that low block. He's going to be an all about driven power jam for Dream Show in Horror Quinn. Smack Mamba approaching. Getting ready to hit the pack.
That's going to be Smack Mamba's fifth penalty. She better watch it.
With that call, Horror Quinn gets to one pack. Destruction pack being called on Sissus Lander.
In very sparkly shorts. Smack Mamba making her way to that front of the pack as she replaces the jammer cover on her helmet.
Smack Mamba taking out the jammer cover on her helmet. The jammer short pass. Got to see it on the cover. And Horror Quinn calls it. Not before putting up one more point, 11-0 jam for Jersey Shore.
That's terrific. That's the highest jammer score for the second half, but it's also the highest jammer score for Jersey Shore overall. For the second half, sorry. Second highest. Oh my goodness, it's late, folks.
We did not respond to that jammer. Emma Effa.
Emma Effa.
High pop assess to Emma Effa. He's been doing all about driven power jam through the Lady Dauntless in River City. Lady Dauntless now approaching. He has one pair of hits, two hits up. Fast ninja. Knock off. What a bat, 5 in the sky for the girls in River City. The girls approaching again. Oh, just a nice screen there. Just a nice, easy position with blocking. Allows the girls to get all 5 points on that pass. The girls coming through for another pass. One to beat in the front, Emma Effa rejoining the action. One to beat in the front, and Abbasia Liva gets her on her initial. Lady Dauntless coming through for another. Gets blocked to the outside by Gamingham, making pass it off. No more points, but 15-0 River City. 16-0 River City, 199-6-3. Under 25 minutes to play in this matchup.
We got Adrenaline and Slammabelly coming in for jam number 5. Just like the first half, the second half also has alternating lead jams so far. Let's see if that will trend to continue. Adrenaline getting lead jammer this go round.
High block on 414. That's going to be her sixth.
Her sixth penalty for 414. That is Jersey Shore player Mick Jagger. Adrenaline calling off the jam, scoring 2 points, bringing River City over the second century mark, 201-63. Horror Quinn wearing the star for Jersey Shore and Country Jam for River City.
Country Jam decides to win on the inside lead jammer for River City. Horror Quinn They're making their way through the pack. Christian James just goes in the back of that play. Kumar getting 4 points. Horror thing. Diving into him is Country Man Carl. Not 205-6-3.
Available in a full range of harvesters from 84A
all the way up to 101-8. There is a halo for everyone.
So it looks like number 679 of Jersey Shore Roller Girls, that is Sissy Slammer, has in fact fouled out. She has been escorted off the track, and another player is currently serving time in the box on her behalf.
So, holding two out the racer, River City Jam, at 25 points, I believe Brown has the highest for a jam of the game. The very first game today. I think Bobby just wants to brag about that. How many of you played in the 10 o'clock game?
Alright, take a seat, Kate.
I was 16 of day 2 of ECX 2018. One of the several Brazilian WFPDA recognized tournaments. Numbers. It is the point of the night in which the skaters are making the official timeout signal.
This is the time of the night where you see start to see dancing on the track, you start to see hugging. To fall asleep.
I'm personally awake, eating all these chocolate covered espresso beans.
I know, I don't think I'm
going
to be able to sleep. It's raw
and if I come around a little dance on the inside, just clap and that nice maneuver. Pitcher up there coming through 12 points. Royal Rumble City. And Evan is called it off. He's able to get 3 points. Here's the show coming up on top, 8-4 Jam. Sunday, we are online. For here's the show going up against Smack Mob before River City. Both these teams, and excuse me, very short, pack advantage. Mario dancing around the outside, Lee Brennan from River City. Slay with that Lee.
Looks like he's getting caught up by a black ninja. And Blonde Friday putting up a strong defense, trying to prevent Slay with that Lee. Looks like he's got a low block being sent, sending Black Smack Mamba to the penalty box. Slay with that Lee going to try to rack up them points. For that All About Derby power jam!
This is going to be a 2-minute jam.
Another 2-minute jam. They just love their 2-minute jams in this game.
It's just an endurance contest at this point.
Are you jelly of the jam?
Not really. Hard pass. And out of play block sends Boston Ninja through the box. Smack Mamba back in the action, drops a hit for Winter. Slammer by Lee now throws, she's putting up 4 points. Smack Mamba coming through. Oh, another scoring pass. Low touches some traffic in the front, but she's still throwing another electric points.
Like a gauntlet of Jersey Shore skaters who have to make their way through to score those points.
Matt, let's see what's up now. We snap Mamba. Getting the drug out there around turn four. This pack taking up about half of the track. Then the lead though. He's a 4 points, a big jam with a slam of the lead. 13-8 jam, Jersey Shore just shy.
Wow.
Excuse me, 13-11 jam. Jersey Shore just shy of cracking the century mark.
That was a good showing for Jersey Shore. That was Jersey Shore's highest scoring jam of the second half. And the second highest of the game. So let's see who we got next. We got Emma Effa wearing the star for Jersey Shore and number 13, American Gothic, her first time as jammer. But Emma Effa, a little too quick. A little too quick on her feet. She's lead jammer. American Jam, or American Gothic, not too far behind. Mixing up Country Jam and American Gothic. We've got American Jam. But Emma Effa is in your lead jammer. Oh, a forearm penalty being assessed on American Gothic, leaving Emma Effa on an All About Derby power jam. That is back-to-back power jams for Jersey Shore, and they have now officially crossed the century mark thanks to Emma Effa and the power jam.
Emma Effa, 2-4-5 for the grand slam. She only got 14 on the jam.
Emma Effa calling off the jam. She has racked up 16 points. 16 points. Two more sneaky points. That is the highest of the game for Jersey Shore. 252 to 113. Slammable Lee and Adrenaline going in for jam number 13, just outside of 12 minutes left of the second half, the last game of the night on track two. That is the first time that is the ninth jam where River City has not scored a single point. But it looks like we've got an overturn. Slamabelle Lee is sitting in the penalty box for a crack cut. Adrenaline gonna make the best of that.
Pull
power jam, that
all about
Derby power jam.
Nicky Murphy is sliding the ball into the bag, but she's trying to put a slam. 5-0 to the points for the River City. Adrenaline now reapproaching to the B in the front. Slamabelle Lee though coming through from the back. Still goes to honor to Adrenaline for the three. She got 4-5-1 called off. 10-0 Grand River City. Hail Satan.
That's a great name.
Team. No, really sure.
Hail Satan.
Hail Satan.
Oh, and a tumble.
No.
A tumble to the floor. But Satan recovers to get lead jammer status over Laura Quinn.
Well, guys, it's nice to turn out in the show. Coming through. Oh, there's a knock to the inside of the way. That's a burner to the far boy. Satan's going to get knocked by Kurt Murphy. Oh, big hit, and I think that's another throw coming out on Kurt Murphy. Well, Satan's going to run for 5 points. But he uses Satan, but I cannot stop saying, hail Satan. Satan on the inside line. 10 points so far. Star pass to number 6 Candace Tina Slay.
That is the first star pass of the game.
Satan's number 3 picks up only 3. And Tina Slay takes a little slay ride on Blast the Ninja. Just knocked it out. Satan coming through. Trying to find some daylight. Meanwhile, Tina Slay getting through.
Tina Slay finally getting a chance to put that star on her helmet. Now
we just got on Cassie Lemuel. 2 more points for Satan. 15 points.
277-113 is where the score is currently sitting. Going into jam number 15. A little bit more than 8 minutes left of this second half in their fourth regulation play. Emma Effa facing off against Smack Mamba. That is a familiar pairing that we've seen so far tonight. Smack Mamba trying to take that inside line, but it looks like she got hit to the inside courtesy of Nikki Knuckles. That leaves Emma Effa free to take lead jammer status while Smack Mamba is still stuck at the back of the pack. But she's being called on a track cut, leaving Emma Effa free to reign with a All About Derby power jam.
Emma Effa. I want to say one of the most productive jammers for the jammer show.
Absolutely. She's a very strong jammer. I've seen her play before. Many times. Oh, and a shoulder hit delivered to Blondsided. Blondsided got blindsided.
I see what she did there. And the Echo coming through tries to get some offense for a number four, Reapers. We're going to get out on our own. Smack Mamba to chase for this area for some folks. And a forearm. Oh, forearm calling Smack Mamba. Excuse me. Forearm calling Smack.
That is Milk and Cookies getting a forearm.
Milk and Cookies getting that forearm.
That's a great name, too.
15. So 15 point by River City was answered by a 15 point jam by Jersey Shore. 277 to 128, under 7 minutes left in this game.
Flammabelle Lee going up against Lady Dauntless, jam number 16.
Flammabelle Lee. Lady Dauntless comes through. Lee Jammer. 3 out of 4 leads for Lady Dauntless in this match. Samba Limit Man to the inside by Blasky Ninja. And Lady Dauntless here on the outside, 5 big points for Lady Dauntless in River City. Samba Limit still caught up in the flat. She is not to be out. And by Country Jam. And Lady Dauntless puts a 5 in the sky for River City. She's been exceptional for about 2 minutes. Slammer Lee now working against the chest of Country Jam and the side of blindsided.
Flammabelle Lee trying to move that wall of River City skaters. Slowly but surely trying
to make her way out of that pack.
Number. She got knocked out. She's
going
to have to recycle to the back of the pack.
Number 5 for the finish for again, a pull of going to the back. Lady Dauntless. Ooh. Oh, runs into 1-2. 5 more points. 20 points on the board for Lady Dauntless in River City. Flammabelle Lee getting knocked around like a rag doll.
Oh boy. He does not have
right back by Crimson Jam and Blaster Ninja.
Flammabelle Lee definitely having a tough time this jam, whereas River City just 25 points in this jam. That's the highest of the half, courtesy of Lady Dauntless. They've passed the 300 mark. It ties the second highest score in the game. And there's the jam. 29
points
in
a
single jam. That is
now the highest, 306 to 128. Huge jam there for Lady Dauntless. Incredibly productive jam for River City.
Absolutely. And here's Emma Effa once again, and Adrenaline once again for River City and Jersey Shore.
Adrenaline tries to run out the up and the outside of the line, but Emma Effa getting through. Sweet jamming.
Emma Effa is 4 for 5 in this second half.
And Effa coming through on screen attack. She's generally not far behind her. Emma Effa looking to get some points and send the bleeding to that huge jam. Our Blasty knocks it to the outside. She's going to call it up. 4 points. She's an 8-4 jam, Jersey Shore. Pushing at the point. And Nia Jay getting caught on the back of Prince Bird. Everybody jams.
Tina Slay has served as jammer before and the result is a star pass. This is her first official jammer jam. But it looks like Lakshmi Mitra is taking lead jammer status. And Tina Slay getting knocked to the outside, having to go all the way to the back of the pack. Whereas Lakshmi Mitra is taking 5 points home to River City.
Tina Slay, pops off a hit by Snap Movement and Brownsliding. That's the mention of approaching for Wilson, because pops the side of work and Tina Slay getting popped to the inside.
That part of the track that just causes everybody to fall down. There must be like a divot or something.
I think it's people.
Oh, slam
of Belly. Oh no, Blackskin Ninja.
Four penalty being called on Blackskin Ninja. That's a 2 minute jam. Tina Slay gonna try to take full advantage of this All About Dirty Power Jam as the clock runs down.
When the fuel clock runs out, 24 seconds left in the jam clock. Jersey Shore rushes Tina Slay, going to be 5 in the slot for Jersey Shore. Jersey Shore back turning the baseboards.
Here's a weekend update for you.
Basket picks up approaches with Tina. Jersey Shore doesn't really catch it and gets through.
It was an exciting ending, but it looks like River City, unofficially River City is taking home the win. 315-148, we will be back with your final score once it is confirmed by the officials, but it looks like River City, it was a hell of a game, it was a great game, it was an exciting game. Both teams played super hard. Looks like we're just waiting on that official score. And there we have it, your final score, River City victorious, 319-148. Congratulations, River City. Congratulations to everybody who stuck around. Congratulations to the production team. Congratulations to you, Kate Silver.
Congratulations to you, Jason. Congratulations to the officials. And congratulations to Philly Roller for completing another great day of ECBS.
Have a good night, everybody. I'm Kosher Nostra.
I'm Kate Silver. And we're supported by our wonderful producing team in Blind Grace and Bobby Narco.
Absolutely. Get home safe, everybody. Drive safe. Be well. We'll see you tomorrow.